I know what y'all thinking. Y'all thinking how they hired a stand-up comedian that can't stand up. I know.
Yeah, man, I've been having car trouble lately. It's terrible, man, when you don't have AAA. All I got is A. Like, hey, man, can you help me push this to the gas station real quick? Hey, you think you got some jumbo cables I can borrow?
Send greetings from Jamaica. The people back home, they wanted me to tell you that this one thing. They wanted me to tell you that, I'm sorry, I get a little emotional when I think about it, but they wanted me to tell you that I'm not from Jamaica, I'm from Brooklyn. I was actually born in Brooklyn, and but I know some Jamaicans, though.
Like, I've been realizing that people, they lie about stuff when they need stuff, and I don't like that. Like, for instance, somebody asked me for a ride home the other day, and the way I gauge whether or not I want to take you home is I ask the question, where do you live? And they tell me, right up the street. Let me tell you something, you got to investigate people's right up the street. You tell me what? All right, can I make a right here? Can I go up the next six lights? Can I jump on the freeway real quick?
I'm 6'7" tall. People are always asking me that magical question. Hey, man, you play basketball? You shoot who? You know, when I tell them no, they always look at me with this real disappointment. Like, you don't play no basketball? Look at you. You're just wasting your life. Look at you. Just wasting your height. Look at you. You should be playing for the Lakers somewhere. Look at you. Just tall for nothing. Look at you. But that's real stereotypical. What if I was to do that to people? You know what I mean? Like a heavyset person. Be like, dang, bruh, how much you weigh? And you don't sumo wrestle or nothing, huh? You ain't in no pie-eating contest or nothing. Look at you. Just wasting all your bigness.
Can you imagine what it would be like to go to the Italian preacher's church? Because to me, Italians, I affiliate them with the mob. You know what I mean? Could you imagine what it would be like to go? Because to me, they'll offer you Jesus like it's a drug deal. Hey, come on over here. Let me ask you a question. Are you happy living life the way you're living it, huh? What are you doing? Drinking the booze? Smoking the tweets over there? Well, if I got news for you, now what do you say? You let Jesus come into your life. He'll make you a brand new creature. By the pool, by the thing you say, huh? What do you say, huh? Your sins, forget about it.
This is my guy Vito over here. This is my muscle. Alright, this is guy, he's Sicilian. You can see he's got the dark skin. This is my Jamaican Italian.
Jamaican Italian.
Jamaican Queens, you know?
What's your motto? What's your name gonna be?
I'm Mickey.
Mickey.
Mickey and Vito. These are my guys. Now my toughest guy, he's not here right now, but that's Vinny. You see him a little bit later.
You know, I'm a Lakers fan, and I want him to like the Lakers too, but he's a LeBron James fan. He likes the Heat. Any Heat fan in here? Okay, don't get shot tonight. Don't get shot. Right. So my son, he want to ask me for a pair of Jordans. I'm like, you might get a pair of Jordan Farmars, but you might get no Michael Jordans. You might get some Jordan Sparks, but you... That ain't sure I'm finna get no Michael Jordans.
You want to see the thug give his life to the Lord? That is the funniest thing. It ain't funny that he gives his life to the Lord. It's funny how he gives his life to the Lord. Because the pastor, it's always the same. The pastor be like, young man, lift both of your hands as a barometer as to how much you're ready to receive Jesus in your life. And they'll be like, lift them all the way up, young man. Stay up, cuz, stay up. So finally, the pastor, he prays the sinner's prayer, you know what I mean? The man, he accepts Christ into his life, and then the thug, he just starts crying, you know what I mean? He starts crying. And the pastor be like, young man, why are you crying? And the thug be like, boo! You don't even know, cuz! crying because I love the Lord, homie. I got a testimony too. When I first walked up in the sanctuary, that usher back there was being me. He wouldn't let me sit next to my auntie. I was gonna sock us. Ooh, you don't know who you're messing with. I'm from 106 in Park, homie.
So y'all know, man, I like to take Jesus with me everywhere that I go, especially in the carpool lanes. But the police, they don't seem to understand that. I got pulled over by a cop. He gonna ask me, excuse me, sir, do you know why I'm pulling you over? I'm like, no, I don't know why you're pulling me over. He's like, well, you're in the carpool lane and you're by yourself. I'm like, that's where you're wrong. See, I have Jesus in the car with me. He gonna get smart with me and be like, well, Jesus ain't got a seatbelt on, so that's gonna be 2 tickets.
Looking for a miracle.